Hello, everybody. BeMetalways here. Hope you're all doing well. Today, I'm gonna come back to the 13 albums that have shaped my musical life. And this is part 4 and last. Now, I must confess that I'm cheating here a little bit. So we already covered the 13 albums. But this part 4 will actually cover 10 albums. So the top 10 albums that shaped my musical life post 2005. So parts 1, 2, 3, we covered the top 13 that shaped my musical life. I covered the first two waves of albums that shaped my life. The first one in the mid 80s and when I rediscovered metal in the mid 90s. Now I want to reflect two more waves, the mid 2000s and the early 2010s. So let's get started with wave 3. And I'll speed it up so I can cover those 10 albums in a reasonable amount of time. First one in this wave 3 is Christ Illusion by Slayer, released in 2006. I was living in the US at the time and I was bored with the radio-friendly and classic rock that I was listening to there, so I decided to explore heavier stuff. One of the critics that I respected a lot at the time elected this album as one of the best of that year, and even though I had Show No Mercy, their first album from back in the day, I never really got into them. Well, I loved Christ Illusion, and next thing I know, I really finally rediscovered Slayer and especially Raining Blood, that became one of my favorite albums of all time. The whole discography and the rest is history. Since then, Slayer is one of my favorite bands. Next to that is a very different album, is the Roundhouse Tapes by Opeth, released in 2007. Classmate and the guitar player on my band at the time suggested to me to check Opeth. I got two tracks from the live album from iTunes, Windowpane and Bleak. I remember being so impressed and I was sure they had two singers. Even though I loved those songs for some reason, I only come to explore the full discography with the release of Heritage in 2011. Next is Ascendancy by Trivium, released in 2005. The same friend also suggested Trivium as quote-unquote the next Metallica or something, and I remember Like Light to the Flies became a personal favorite. Luckily, I started with what's arguably their best album yet. Other songs are also great. They didn't become as big as we expected back then, but the most important thing is that it opened my mind to give a chance to new modern bands. Which leads me to Killswitch Engage and The End of a Heartache, which was released in 2004. And finally, the same guy also gave his third tip, which was to watch a show from Killswitch Engage. I will never forget the powerful performance from Howard Jones back then, you know, Adam's killer riffs, and most importantly, the mix of screams and clean vocals was really an eye-opener to me. I was caught up by surprise and I was really impressed. As a result, Killswitch Engage was a perfect way into this style of metal. Years have passed and to this day is one of my favorite bands within this genre. The next one is The Blackening by Machine Head. I had only heard about the band until they opened for Heaven and Hell in 2007, I think. So I got a couple of songs via iTunes. It was Halo and Imperium. Love at first sight, guys. I had no idea that The Blackening would become such a classic record, and until today, their best album by far. That was a very good start to a new band. That leads me to wave 4, and we're talking about 2011 and 12. Was a transformation year for me, where a lot of things changed. I start to explore even more bands in metal. So the first one is Mastodon, 2011's The Hunter. I had never heard of the band when The Hunter was released, and it took me 1 year to understand it and get into their sound. Better late than never, right? So the thing is, this is one of their weakest albums. So you can imagine, as I discovered, that they were even better than that, better than I thought. So by now, they became one of my favorite modern bands, that's for sure. Talking about modern, next one on the list is Meshuggah with Colossus. I was hypnotized by this album. I listened to Do Not Look Down more than 70 times just in my PC, and I know that because the iTunes count. But the real game changer was seeing them live. What an experience that is. After that, they became a favorite band. One of the best metal shows that I've been in the last decade. Looking back, discovering the discography was a very welcome. Next on the list is Periphery number 2. This time it's Personal by obviously Periphery, released in 2012. I saw an interview with John Petrucci talking about Periphery, who were opening for Dream Theater at the time. I watched Icarus Lives on YouTube and was really impressed. But instead of buying the debut, I got their newest release at the time, and Periphery 2 became my album of the year in 2012. I really like all the albums that followed as well. Alright, so talking about crazy modern prog, the next one is Between the Buried and Me, the Parallax 2 Future Sequence, released in 2012. This was actually my first BT Band album, and I loved it for that. After getting into Periphery, I bought a ticket for a show of both bands together. BT Band was promoting Parallax 2, so I listened to it and to Colors as well. From there, I started to dig their whole discography, and they became one of my favorite prog metal bands today. Alright, we're down to the last one on the list. And this is also from 2012. Atlas by Parkway Drive. Despite being a fan of Killswitch Engage for some time at this point, overall, I was not yet willing to try other bands considered anything core related. But those Australians, very metallic metalcore, convinced me to give it a try. It worked, and from there I have embraced their full discography and added a few metalcore bands to my list of favorite modern bands. It was a bit of a quickfire challenge here. I covered a lot of ground. 10 albums released in the 2000s that shaped my musical life since 2005. So thanks for watching. I hope you like this. Please subscribe, like, share, join my channel, and help me out here, and be mad always!